Hi, it's Anne Emery with Excel for Evaluators. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to use conditional formatting to highlight your blank cells. So let's take a look at my data. This is real demographic data showing all the people who were served by a nonprofit organization 1 year. And let's just scroll through the data set and explore it a little bit. So we can see that we have some missing data. Here's a whole chunk of missing data. It's all over the place. Here's some missing data. Here's some more missing data. Data could be missing from this data set for probably two main reasons. One is that when people came in to the nonprofit organization and filled out an enrollment form, they just simply skipped the question. Maybe they didn't know the answer. Maybe they didn't understand the question on our demographic form. Another possibility is that the staff at the organization just forgot to enter that data into our database because these questions weren't required. They didn't have to enter that data, so it's possible they just skipped it by mistake. So let's see how much missing data we actually have. I'm going to use the Countblank formula just to quickly assess it. So do equals Countblank, open your parentheses, and select the range of data that you want. So in this case, it's the entire column B where I've got the gender. Close your parentheses, press enter, and I'm missing 53 people's gender right here. We're going to look for this small little box in the lower right-hand corner, drag this across, and it fills in the blanks for all of our variables. So you can see we have a huge amount of missing data when it comes to country of birth, when they moved to the United States, and their language. And you can share this data with the program staff and you can tell them, hey, we don't know the country of birth for 410 people. But that number, you know, it doesn't really have much meaning for them. They need to visually see it to be able to kind of figure out how big of a problem that is. So that's when I use conditional formatting. So I'll show you what it looks like. Let's highlight all of our data. It's a lot of data right here, about 1,200 people. Okay. Make sure you're on the Home tab at the top. Look for the button that says Conditional Formatting. Click on it. Go to Highlight Cells Rules and go all the way down to the bottom where it says More Rules. This is what the default screen looks like. It says format only cells width. We're going to change this to blanks. And you can see nothing happens in the preview. It says no format set. So we need to change the formatting a little bit. And I like to fill the cells. Let's go to fill and let's fill them with red so that that shows that there's a problem. Kind of like the stoplight colors. Green is good, yellow is caution, red is bad. So we'll click OK. And OK again, and now the blank cells are automatically shaded in red. So as you scroll through, and we can even zoom out a little bit so you get the bigger picture, we've got a lot of missing data here. If you send this spreadsheet to the program staff, this seems to hit home a little bit more, and they understand that maybe they need to do a little bit better job collecting this data in the first place or just entering it in the database a little bit more carefully. So there you have it, conditional formatting to highlight your blank cells. Thank you.